Country, kingscountry.net. Good morning. It's a TGIF edition of the Jim King of the Radio Show. Friday, August 5th, 2022. We are 28 days until Labor Day weekend, 13 days until morning show boot camp. Today is International Beer Day. I drank to that, but it's still a little bit too early, and I'm kind of switched to whiskey. But FYI. But TMI, too much information. Here's some back-in-the-day tidbits for you. 161 years ago on this date, 1861, do the math. Abraham Lincoln signed the first federal income tax into law. The 3% tax was applied to all incomes over $800. And that was the beginning of socialism. Not. 108 years ago today, 1914, the first electric traffic lights were installed in Cleveland. And finally, 60 years ago on this date, 1962, Marilyn Monroe's housekeeper discovered Marilyn's beautiful nude body in the bedroom at her Los Angeles home. Her death was ruled a possible suicide from an overdose of barbiturates. Again, it's a TGIF edition as we keep it on a roll with Don Williams this morning.
Likely as not, there's been better weather.
King's Country at kingscountry.net. It's Jim King of the radio. I don't talk about it much, but I do have a tat. Yeah, one tattoo. I got it for my 50th birthday from Flipper Skin Flicks over there in Bridge City. He's the best. He's the bomb. He actually drew out my company logo, and that's what I've got tattooed on my upper right shoulder. It's the classic Cadillac logo with my hat, my official Crown Boy hat dangling on the top of it. You've seen it probably if you watched the show. Anyway, speaking of tats, a British OnlyFans celebrity claims that she has the most tattooed private parts in the world. In fact, she had to do 5 separate sessions for that area of her body alone. In total, she spent over $42,000 on tattoos. Here's Becky Holt talking about how people question her parenting because of the sheer amount of tattoos.
I've been called a bad mother because of my tattoos. I've been told that my daughter would be embarrassed at me when she's older. I don't see why having tattoos makes me any less of a parent than somebody who doesn't have tattoos.
Coming to you from the studios of King of the Road Productions in Beaumont, Texas. We're always cooking up something new for the boob tube. Yep, it's my time to shine on the television on the boob tube this weekend. 3 times on Fox 4 and the CW. Known as the Jim King of the TV show. Don't you dare miss it. And you'll be able to stream the segments on demand starting tomorrow at jimkingoftheroad.com. And this one, by popular demand, we've got Frank Martin Gilligan back in the royal spotlight thanks to Bradley's Collision Center. Southeast Texas debut of Tim Duggar's new video as our Pine Tree Lodge music clip of the week from Nashville. We're going to kick it off with John Conley live at the old Whiskey River. We're dipping into our royal archives for this episode. We're going to follow it up with Johnny Lee from the same concert. Here's a little snippet, a little taste test.
It's nice to be here with John Conley tonight, huh? Catch myself listening to him a lot. We do a few shows together. He's got some great songs, and it's always good to be with John. It's great to be with y'all tonight. Picking up strangers, let me tell you about the danger. You never know what they're out to get from you. Never know what they're gonna try to do. Picking up strangers. Heart.
great to see you again.
Good to see you again, man.
It's been a couple of years, and I think the last time might have been right here at Whiskey River.
It was, and I have some very fond memories. I may have some jewelry on layaway in Beaumont somewhere. I don't know.
It's a very memorable night, and I know you do have a lot of fun at your shows, and you still got the pipes. You and John Connolly both. I mean, you guys sound like no different or even maybe better than you did in the 80s.
It's a little bit easier now than it was in the 80s. You know, I was pretty hard to keep up with back then. I like to party a lot, you know.
Yeah.
A little bit of party goes a long way with me now, but... John's got some great songs. He's always had some great songs. I love listening to him sing, you know. And thank you for the compliment.
You bet, man. I was brushing up on my John Connolly and Johnny Lee facts today, and I was amazed to find out that you guys were born a month apart. You know that?
I didn't realize that.
And not only that, but you
both... He older than me?
I think so, by 1 month.
I thought so. Yeah, I thought he looked a little older than me.
You were born in July?
Yeah.
He was born in August.
Yeah.
Yeah, I won't say what year.
That's okay. And I was born in 1946. Man.
I know.
I never thought I'd live to be past 20. So it's all good with me.
Born and raised on a dairy farm.
I was born in Texas City. And the only reason I was born there because my mother had a choice of crossing her legs and holding out or going to a veterinarian when it was time for me to come. So thank goodness they took her to a hospital.
King of the Road.
Here comes this week's Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback. Weird, buddy. You spent 10 years with Mickey Gilley.
Who?
You don't remember?
No, I still talk to Gilley all the time. Talked to him yesterday. He was in Nashville doing a Time Life Warner thing, you know, something that he's doing. And then he was going to Faraday, Louisiana to do a homecoming thing. I thought that was pretty cool. I was in Georgia. I met this chick down there, and she took me to an antique show. And I was walking around, you know, looking at stuff and everything. And this little lady came up. She said, "Have you ever been to an antique show before?" I said, "Yes, ma'am. I've seen Mickey Gilley 3 times.
I ain't got my name in the marquee lights.
King of the Road.
That was this week's Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback. Check out Johnny Lee, John Connolly, Tim Duggar, and Frank Martin Gilligan on this weekend's Jim King of the TV Show. Of course, you want to see the Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback and the Sonky Bottom Saloon Events calendar. And thanks for streaming King's Country on this TGIF. King's Country at kingscountry.net. I'm Jim King of the Radio. If you reside in Southeast Texas and are near a boob tube, you can flip over to Channel 6 and watch Noon News. Could have some rain in the forecast. Get the forecast and then get a preview of this weekend's Jim King of the TV Show. It's the one where we're going to reach into our royal archives and pull out some John Connolly and Johnny Lee. Plus, Frank Martin Gilligan will be in the royal spotlight. Got a great new video from Tim Duggar. Check out the preview during Noon News, usually around 12:15, 12:20, and then flip over back over to us and stream the most magnificent country music mix on the planet 24/7 and 365. And stay with me for Eddie Arnold right after these.
Bradley's Collision Center delivers expert truck, RV, and auto body repair and service to the Golden Triangle.
Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Look, up in the sky. It's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's
King. Tough job, but somebody's got to do it. Here I am hanging out with the Houston Rockets power dancers and the Houston Texan cheerleaders. It's the Houston Rockets power dancers.
Yes.
I feel the power. I always like to say I feel the crown power, too, from my crown boy hat. I bet you've never seen a hat like that before.
I have not. No, I haven't.
You girls look really cute wearing something like this.
Maybe.
But you look awful cute anyway. Now you're at all the home games for the Houston Rockets?
Yes, all the home games. You'll find us there.
Last year they had the Houston Texan cheerleaders here.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Have you ever met a real king before?
A real king, not before you.
Good.
You're the only one.
Good, because I'm really not a real king. I just play one on TV a couple of times a week.
King of the Road.
Am I dreaming or stupid?
King's Country, kingscountry.net. I'm Jim King of the radio. Do you think that these big country stars get starstruck themselves sometimes? I sometimes feel that. Not very often, but there's some people I get to meet that I feel a little bit of starstruckness. Well, Maren Morris can only remember one artist who made her starstruck. Want to guess who it is? Hint. He's from England. He's a rocker. It was the time she had tea with Elton John. Here's Maren Morris.
I feel like the only time I've ever really been, like, starstruck is maybe sitting and having tea with Elton John. I'm one of many artists that did all these Elton John songs for this compilation project, and he invited all the artists. We had high tea with him. I just, like, sat with him, and we talked about how he loves country music. He always has. He said that he feels like he was a country artist in a previous life. So that was one where I was like, oh, my God, this is insane that I'm sitting here just having tea with a knight.
King's Country at kingscountry.net. It's Jim King of the radio driving you through the lunch hour. Oh, and here comes my buddy Mark Chestnut with his classic Old Country. That explains why I'm having one of them there. Fabulous flashbacks. Could get bumpy. Hold on.
King of the road.
Backstage at the Texas Crab Festival in Crystal Beach with Mark Chestnut.
Wouldn't for your memory, I'd been here all alone. Goodbye, heartache, darling, welcome home.
Of course, Mark Chestnut's home has always been right here in Southeast Texas, where he began performing while still in his teens.
Been having a ball since I was a boy in Beaumont.
I still live in Southeast Texas, I'm never going to leave it. I've never moved to Nashville. I go there when they force me.
Did they encourage you to move to Nashville in the early years, in the early 90s?
No, really, they didn't. They, I thought they would, but when I signed on with MCA, I thought for sure, they were telling me what to wear, what not to wear, and how to act and everything like that. But I thought for sure, they're going to try to make me move up here. Mm-hmm. And they never did. They wanted me to stay in Southeast Texas because, we have a unique sound that comes out of this area.
And yeah, it's a very rich music scene here all over Texas, really, but especially Southeast Texas.
Really is. Southeast Texas is real special. It has its own vibe, and you can hear any type of music that you want to hear. If you want to hear country music, honky-tonk music, Cajun music, swamp pop, rock and roll, everything, and you can see it live.
I met a girl out in eastern Oklahoma. Daddy was a Tulsa millionaire.
King's Country at kingscountry.net. Did you know that it's international beer day? Yes, it is. I used to be a big beer connoisseur till I met Suzanne Simmons, and then I tried to lose some weight. We've been on a diet for over a year. It's kind of up and down here and there, but I cut out beer, and I think that helped a lot. I love Dos Equis when we go out. I'll have a cold Dos Equis dressed. I know it's TMI, too much information, but I like it dressed with a little salt and a little lime. But speaking of beer, it is International Beer Day, as I still sip on a little H2O here at the castle. Cat Castle, excuse me. Enjoying International Beer Day. I may celebrate and have one later.
International Beer Day.
International Beer Day.
Beer, beer, beer. I'm going for a beer.
Beer is good. Beer is good.
Time to head for the best tasting beer you can find.
All we need is a chair and a cooler beer.
You know the deal. Let's get a beer.
Beer it up.
We've got the beer.
She's the first shot creeping up, hit you just the right way.
King's Country, kingscountry.net. Of course, I run a little local business here. It's the King of the Road Production Studios where we produce this TV and radio show. And I occasionally use PayPal and Venmo. Yeah, we take credit cards. We take PayPal. So if you want to send me a credit card payment, go right ahead. We take PayPal, Venmo, credit cards. And here's a financial expert on why you should not keep large amounts of money in Venmo or PayPal.
My friend, he showed me that he had $22,000 sitting in his Venmo. Now, this is pretty crazy, but there are a few problems with this. Number one, he's not getting interest. Number two, Venmo is owned by PayPal since 2012. If you hold a PayPal balance, basically they combine your balance with the balances of other users and invest those funds in liquid investments. So they're going to be making money on your unused funds. And number three, in the unlikely event that they go bankrupt, your money is not insured by them. Moral of the story, don't leave too much in Venmo.
Outskirts of heaven.
King's Country at kingscountry.net, putting the ribbon on a TGIF edition of the Jim King of the Radio Show. Don't miss the Jim King of the TV Show three times this weekend on Fox 4 and the CW. And as always, I'll be posting the segments at jimkingoftheroad.com and my YouTube channel tomorrow so you can stream them on demand. Wrapping up production here today, had a few little odds and ends to take care of, and then I'm going to go pick up my sweetheart, Suzanne Simmons, and we're going to go see the debut in Southeast Texas of Bullet Train, starring Brad Pitt, one of our favorite actors, very charismatic guy. I'll report back next week on how we liked Bullet Train. As I cruise out of here in the Black Bullet, you keep it between the ditches. Have a good one. Talk to you Monday, 10-ish, right here on King's Country.
Sitting there.